I mean, I feel like we should see the tater tot booth.
Jim, I love you.
I love you too. It's my dad. So embarrassing. Here we are, Bourbon and Beyond, which of course originally was Bourbon Bath and Beyond. Look at this. Wow. 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 Now, you know, last night they had 60,000 people here. Here's guest services. So I can ask you for help. I have a severe drinking problem.
We have a sober lounge. What you're going to do is head that way.
Is it true that sober lounge, people just walk by and go, quitter, quitter? Tyler, here we are. We all know you live in the U-Haul. What's your favorite part about Bourbon and Beyond?
The amount of music that we have to listen to.
Yeah.
The amount of bourbon we have to drink.
Yeah.
Those two are beautiful things to meld together.
Rabbit hole. This is bourbon that's made in a rabbit hole. Now, I'm just hesitant because I'm allergic to rabbits. This is an aroma wall. That's cinnamon. Is that mint? Is that supposed to smell like creepy old guy? And how often are you hired as a Freddie Mercury lookalike? Why Starlight?
So my dad wanted to gather the farmers around us into this distillery, so he named it after the towns.
And Starlink, so your dad is Elon Musk. Starlink, that's different from Starlight.
Correct.
How's it going? Is that pizza? I've never tried pizza. Is it good?
You can have a bite. From the end.
From the end.
Yeah.
Can I lick the whole piece?
No, absolutely not.
Don't get too drunk. I know how you can be. Look where she's going. Go see it. Bar service. So weird. She was already drunk.
You got to ride the edge if you're going to be innovative and try something different. You know, like using sounds to, you know, penetrate more into the barrel.
What does happen when it's exposed to sound?
It's getting a lot more interaction with the barrel in a much shorter period of time.
Oh, wow. Being a Metallica fan, what if you discovered that the sound that provided the best bourbon was John Denver? Ass Pocket Whiskey. So you guys work for Ass Pocket?
Yes.
Do you sell any bourbon that doesn't have a cuss word in it? That's pretty cool, right? Oh, here, if you can grab this. We gotta leave before they want it back. Oh, no, that thing. There's Fred Minnick. You're one of the creators of this. So the Ascot, where did that come from?
It's stuff I watched as a kid, like Love Boat and Magnum PI, like all these cool dudes wore Ascots. And I was like, I wanna wear one of those.
Oh, so like Thurston Howell.
Yeah.
So some of the Ascot awards.
We award like double platinum, platinum, and gold.
Is there a red carpet at the Ascots? And people see what people are wearing? You know, Doja Cat would wear like a barrel.
I don't care, I paint the town red.
Oh, wow. Now, do I eat it with, I'll just use my finger. And so what is this?
Pork chop, bourbon glaze, mustard sauce, Brussels sprouts, and mushroom.
Oh my God. I love this food more than I love my children. Now there isn't pork in this, is there?
There's a little bit of pork.
I just wanted you guys to know that if you come across free bourbon, give it to me. Bourbon Pursuit. I feel like I learned so much from you guys. I'm so indebted to you.
Well, I appreciate it. I mean, we're actually gonna come up on our 10-year anniversary.
I compliment you, but then again, I am still very ignorant. And so that's also your guys' fault. I feel like bourbon is kind of like the adult male action figure.
G.I. Joe!
I think you like the collectability, but then something that you can open and enjoy.
I mean, that's the best time.
Yeah.
Everything's calmed down and you're just sipping on a good bourbon, chatting with friends.
There's a beauty to that. What is the biggest seller for Pappy & Co?
Cigars.
Really?
Yeah.
Because the bourbon balls are pretty amazing.
They are amazing, but obviously we didn't bring them out here because it's been 100 degrees.
Look, there's Jefferson over there. We could probably check that out. Is Thomas Jefferson here?
No, he's not.
Spicy old fashioned, $19. Now, is that US or Confederate?
Please join me in welcoming Mr. Jim Gaffigan.
As the foremost bourbon expert here at Bourbon and Beyond, I am honored to educate these people.
Jim, what got you into
good bourbon, it just works. And by the way, what I'm saying is, I want kids to drink alcohol.
We blast music to our barrels to make them vibrate.
Oh, you do?
Y'all know it's wild.
Can you taste the difference?
Not only can you see a difference and taste a difference, you can feel a difference between your fingers.
Like, I would have them listen to my stand-up. Someone would drink the Fathertime and be like, oh, there's a hint of bacon, or a hint of a Hot Pocket in there.
A hint of irony in here.
A little bit of a Cinnabon or a cake flavor. Is there a president of bourbon, and why am I not the president of bourbon?
That's a great question, because I think you would be a great runner for that.
I would be the Secretary of the Interior of bourbon.
It's yours.
Some
water there.
Yeah, if you want, I can get you a skirt if you want that too.
Now you put a water in there and it opens it up and you get a totally different flavor.
Wait a minute, are you telling me about bourbon?
I am right now.
By the way, can I tell you something? I'm a stand-up comedian who's been in the bourbon industry for about 20 minutes. What is it about Kentucky and bourbon?
Bourbon was born in Kentucky.
Right.
I mean, it's really, truly, and some people may argue with me, it's the only American-born spirit. The culture of bourbon is easygoing. No one's gonna yell at you like you're drinking it wrong. We just want you to drink bourbon. We don't care how you drink it.
If you're in Kentucky, you have to have something on the menu that has a bourbon thing.
We try and make sure that the food is bourbon-friendly.
I think that's the slogan of the day. Being bourbon friendly. The bourbon expression thing, has it reached peak, or is we're still gonna have pizza flavored bourbon in the future?
God, I hope not.
Yeah, we hope not.
I mean, that is a very American thing, right? Scarcity. I learned about scarcity. Stole that from you.
Don't make too much of anything.
Don't make
really
too much.
It's gotta be really good, though.
People want what they can't have. You're all about scarcity, then you had triplets, so. I feel like what's so great about your Instagram thing is the experimental side, but everyone likes good whiskey, but you gotta try different stuff, right?
You have to try things that you don't like, but yeah. On my page, I've chosen to only talk about the good.
There are all these different master distillers, and they're all kind of, they get along. Like, I don't sense any resentment or grudge, but the one thing that they all have in common is their favorite bourbon is Fathertime bourbon.
It's crazy, dude.
Why do you think that Fathertime bourbon is the best liquid that's ever existed?
What's Fathertime bourbon?
That is so cute, how you act. Is it true that you have a child named Fathertime Bourbon?
Yeah.
You, as a master distiller, your favorite bourbon is, of course, Fathertime Bourbon.
Of course it is.
Why is that your favorite bourbon?
You know, it's because my favorite Kamadian made
Kamadian.
It. That's
yeah.
why.
I do have a degree in agronomy.
I've never heard that word before. You just made that up. I'm a professional Kamadian. Is there any truth that you supposedly said that if you buy a bottle of Fathertime bourbon, you will have good luck?
Yeah, I said that this morning, actually. That's pretty messed up that you knew that.
It's nothing creepy, but when you sleep, I watch you.
I cannot absorb enough bourbon culture. I just love every aspect of it. I wish that, as a country, we could come together the way the bourbon industry does, because all these different distillers, you know, they're competing against each other, but there's a civility. It's like, we gotta make America more bourbon.
Make America more bourbon.
Cheers, my friend. Cheers, all you all.